Hey, what's up, everyone? So today we're going to be doing a simple grill swap. The customer has requested to have this aftermarket grill put on here, and they're pretty easy jobs. All you have to do is remove all the clips on the fender liner, the side of the bumper, one that attaches the bumper to the fender that's going from the top down, from the fender down into the actual bumper, and all of your top screws, and the bumper pops off. If you pull your hand from back here and push out, this is a delicate area. I recommend doing that, and you should be good. Other than that is just pushing out this grill with the clips, and it should pop off, and some good easy little money. Apparently someone didn't want to do this job, so they sent it to me, so I'm perfectly fine doing these jobs. They're quick, they're easy, and it's helpful to bring in new clientele, so you make a friend, help them out, and they help you out.
So what tools do you use for them?
We use a butter knife. This Snap-on doesn't sell this. Hornwheel doesn't sell this. What's the other company? Matco doesn't sell this. You're gonna get this at like TJ Maxx, Home Goods, your wife's kitchen drawer. If you can, go to the dollar store and get like 20 of them, or a set of 20, because these are essentials for bumpers. That's why no one wants to do grills and bumpers, because these clips are, they're very tedious. So the trick to this is actually on one of these is pushing back and pushing down. This one seems to be rubbing, so I'm having a hard time pulling it down. So I'm just going to use a screwdriver. If you put your hand in between the bumper, as you go on, you push this tab in and then down. Push it in, then down, in, then down, and then down again. And there you have it. Bumper is off. And now, our next task is going to be I believe it's gonna be getting the bezel off. So that's gonna be getting this outside trim off, and the middle stays, and we swap this this emblem. Get the butter knife again. Oh, I'm gonna have to use the before I get any of that, I'll have to take all of these that's what the butter knives are for. You come in here and you slide these out. And it slides out like butter. That's why you get a butter knife. Now I won't be able to show you guys because I need to get my hand in here.
Should I go on the other side?
Yeah, you can come in here. We'll put that aside. Bring the new grill. Let's check on the back side here. Looks like everything should be lining up. There it goes. That's nothing. Got rubber pads, so there it goes, that snapped in. Again guys, these have rubber pads, so that did the trick. Now we're good. There it goes, snapped in. Snapped in. So, it seems to do the trick. That's in. So now, I can flip this around. And that's how it looks. Now I'll take off the emblem. And voila. So there it goes. So now we are slapping in the bumper back on again. Oh, there we go. So now I can all the screws on.
Why do you jump them around? I put one screw over here and then one over here.
So that the lines, so that I don't end up, if I tighten one side, then that means that the lines won't add up. I make sure that the lines, each hole and bolt line up so that I don't have trouble. If I tighten them all two down, and this, it may be offset. Like, they have a huge hole, so that's not the case here. Like, it didn't matter, I guess, on this occasion. But that's it on this one. Now it just has to be put back on. So now I just have to connect the harness for the fog lamp. Hey, what's going on, guys? So just wanted to show you the finished product on the grill swap. Overall, this took me about an hour and 40 minutes, within that time, I took some calls and was distracted and did a few other things. It may look a little intimidating, but it's not. It's pretty easy job. So yeah, guys, that's it. Thanks for watching, and tune in next time. So that's it for this one, guys. See you on the next one.